Okay, we start with the analysis of a feedback amplifier, general amplifier. The basic amplifier is unilateral. What does that mean? That if you give an input, you will get an output. Okay. It does not mean if you give an input at the output, you will receive anything at the input. So, it is a unilateral device or circuit. However, please remember that when we evaluate for basic amplifier design, even with feedback, if I want to know what is the basic amplifier with feedback, so the first thing I want open loop amplifier. But in evaluation of gain for open loop amplifier, please do not neglect the loadings of components which you are going to create there by feedback. So what essentially we are saying that even if we are looking for open loop circuit, the effect of feedback network and source and load resistances be taken care in your analysis for open loop. So otherwise you will say you remove RF or whatever resistance or impedance you are putting and just do not solve for it. So use that impedance well in the circuit for open loops. Let us see how we will do it. We also assume in most cases that the feedback network is unilateral. Essentially we say there is no or very little feed forward in this case. So when as I again and again saying I am actually first trying to find the open loop gain. Why? Because the closed loop gain with feedback is open loop gain divided by 1 plus A beta. Okay. So I want to know what is AOL, but in evaluation of AOL I do not want to neglect the circuit parts or components which would have come after the feedback. That those I want to retain some way. So I have given, I am writing down here for you, or I have written down for you the steps which you can follow whenever such analysis has to be performed. So the first thing in any feedback amplifier is to identify the topology. What does that mean? Whether the, what kind of feedback is it is, what is the sampling kind, and how it mixes at the input, whether it is series sampled, shunt sampled, series mixed or shunt mixed. And if we know that, then our analysis will become relatively simple if we know which kind of amplifier we are considering. Okay. So first thing is, given a network or amplifier circuit, first find which kind of feedback topology this amplifier has. Then let us say for example if you have a series mixing, and if the in the input circuit, if in the input circuit there is a circuit component say W which is in series with the signal source, then the feedback signal is XF equal to VF is a feedback signal. Okay. So we will see what does that mean. However, if you have a, that means please remember, if it is a series connection it must be voltage in series to the source. Whenever it is series mixing, it has to be a voltage source in series to the signal source. That is what we described as series mixing. However, if you have a shunt mixing, the feedback must return the current, okay, because at that time the current will only allow you to shunt across the input terminals and the source will be current source. Okay. So depending on the kind of input you see, whether you have a feedback which leads to shunt mixing or series mixing, first you should find. If you know series, it is the voltage is in series in the feedback. If it is shunt, then it must be the current which is shunted across. Those topologies which I have given you four figures, please revisit them again and check what I am saying. Is that okay to you? Okay. This is just whatever we did in nutshell I am now saying, so that this is the method you should follow in any amplifier analysis and later on designs. Having seen whether it is which kind of mixing, we also will like to see which kind of sampling. Okay. I repeat, if the sampling is the mixing is series, the feedback must be voltage. If the mixing is in shunt, it must be a current which is in shunt to the input circuit. Is that okay? typically shunt circuit will occur when the current has to be brought there. What kind, where it will, current can be mixed with some other current at a node, is that correct? At a node, voltage can be in series when it is in the mesh, is that correct? Only then it can go into the series of the source, okay. So think of it, whenever there is a node connection feedback, it must be shunt kind. Whenever it is in loop kind of input inside that loop, it must be a series feedback which must be voltage, is that okay? Okay. So obviously in a mesh you cannot have current additions there, okay. So this is trivial but must be understood and must be solved correctly, because otherwise there will be a mischief in actual solvings, okay. So having said that, this is how it will mix. To get the sampling, set the output 0, which is your output, okay. Essentially you say short the load, okay. If now XF becomes 0, that is if output is V0 and you are shorting, and no out in, no feedback will go because part of V0 was to be fed and you are shorted it actually. So if feedback goes to 0, then you must be obviously voltage kind of sampling, which is essentially shunt sampling across the output, is that correct? Across the output means shunt. Figure is shown here. This is my, I have shorted the output, and as soon as I short the output, the feedback goes, okay. Because I say something by V0, and if V0 is not there, there is no feedback there, okay. So once I know it is this kind of circuit I short, and I say I do not see any feedback, then I say I must be having a voltage sampling which we defined as shunt, because it is shunt to the output, therefore it is a shunt sampled. On the contrary, if I make I0 0, which is I open circuit the resistor output load, okay, then if XF becomes 0, then it must be in series to the this, because then you are open circuiting the loop and therefore no current can go, and therefore we say you are series sampling. And that is what the current sampling will be, is that correct? So the conditions you should do, first see at the input side whether your source is getting in the loop of this, then it is a series. If not, it is shunting, then it is a current. So series shunt mixing we know. By making V0 or I0 0, if your feedback goes to 0, we know which kind of sampling we have done, okay. So having now known whether it is series amplifier, series shunt amplifier, shunt series amplifier, or a shunt amplifier, I know which topology now I am at, okay. So given a circuit, first thing you have to find by doing this simple this, which topology we are, because you know in the circuit this kind of network will not be shown, it will be a formal circuit with some components connected left and right, okay. So from there you must be able to figure out which topology we are working at, okay. Also we have seen, depending on the topology, input resistance and output resistance change. In some cases it increases, in some cases it decreases. So the topology will also tell you how the input output will respond to the input side addition, anything coming, or output side when it is driving. So some idea of RI, RO also should be immediately known, because you know now that what kind of amplifier I am working at, is that okay? Now these issues, a priori you do it, because as soon as I put a network or circuit, you should be able to find what I am doing, okay. I have given an example, do not worry that this is the end of it. Now the next step, having found the topology, I want to find amplifier without feedback, and I just said to start with, what I am saying, even if I am want an open loop circuit, I do not say feedback network has been removed, is that point clear? Feedback network has been, I am not saying it, I say I want feedback be broken, but the effect of those components still be taken care, okay. So let us see what I am saying little later. Step A, in the input circuit, if I am looking for what is happening because of the feedback in the input circuit, if you have a shunt sample, make V0 0, and if it is series sample, make I0 0, okay. Essentially the feedback you want to remove, okay. Then the step B is, first I figure out something, I will give you an example. To find an input circuit, make V0, 0 if it is shunt sampled, make I0, 0 if it is series sampled. Now to get an output circuit, what do? Make V input 0, okay, if it is current mixed, and if it is voltage mix, remove the input current. So either of the case, you already find the topology, so which know which ones have to be shorted or opened as for the conditions we have done, okay. Now these two conditions, once we do, इसमें कोई originality नहीं, इसमें आपको एक मैं method इसलिए बता रहा हूँ कि people normally do analysis without knowing also its answers come correct, nothing big about it. But methods, why they are shown these methods? Because they are short, they will simplify your job. That is the only reason we show all the methods. Otherwise, what is the big method is, put whole equivalent circuit and solve. It will always come at the end of the day. Okay. So to even do this, can I small simplify a few things beforehand? I do that. Okay. That is the trick we want to use. So what is that I am trying to say? I want to find the closed loop gain with feedback by not directly calculating with all components present as normally should have been by Kirchhoff's law. What I am going to use the expression for closed loop gain? Open loop gain divided by 1 plus AOL beta. That is the expression I have derived for feedback. So I will say, okay, I will calculate AOL. I have just calculated beta, I substitute. Okay. And I am sure that calculation of AOL will be much simpler than calculate of total ACL. This is my belief. If your, it is not your belief, solve all of it. No one is saying you have to solve ACL by first getting AOL. You actually can solve full network. And once you write an equivalent circuit, you can always find V0 by Vs. Is that clear? So there is that method stands anyway. These techniques are only trying to minimize the effort. So if I get my AOL, fair enough. I know my beta, then AOL upon 1 plus A beta is my closed loop gain, feedback gain. So I just want to do the two steps now. So one of the step I should say, once I know what is XF, because I just know sampling as well as mixing, so I know what XF I am talking, then what X0 I am talking, is that correct? So the ratio of XF by X0 is your beta. Please remember XF, XS is the return path coming from V0 side or I0 side. It can be resistor, it can be conductance, or it can be voltage ratio or current ratio. Is that clear? Four possibility can exist. I may return as a I, V may return as a V, V may return as I may return as V. So in any case, there are four possibilities of the beta's value. Is that clear? Because A beta should not have, A beta should have what units? Irrespective what is A, whether it is current gain, voltage gain, transconductor, what should be the A beta? Non-dimensional, or it should not have unity. That means A beta must be opposite that of A in the units. Is that correct? Therefore, then only it becomes dimensionless. This is essentially what we are saying. Okay. So first find beta, then get AOL beta. If you already calculate AOL, then you get AOL beta, that is T function. Evaluate closed loop, which is also in some books called AF for the amplifier, by what function? AOL upon 1 plus AOL beta is the correct closed loop gain. So evaluate that, and then also evaluate, as we did already earlier, what is its RIF and what is its ROF. These are the three parameters of interest to us other than frequency response, which we will see later. For normal amplifier, first thing I want to know gain, what is, how much gain I got, and what are the input output impedances I am going to get. Okay. So is this method clear to you? So what is first thing we will do? First thing, we must find the topology. To get the topology, we must find what is the kind of mixing and what is the kind of sampling. From there we know what is the feedback going on. Okay. Correspondingly, you actually find your beta. Using the network available of feedback, and that is what to get an AOL, we will see with example that will prove my point. Find AOL, you know the beta, and therefore you know the closed loop gain. But by the same circuit, you can always get your RIF as well as ROF. Let us do one example which will clarify what I am saying. Okay. Okay. In normal cases, unless said otherwise, assume feed forward is negligible. Unless said otherwise, okay. You can see the it is like superposition. We always solve for feedback, okay, and if there is a feed forward, which term will appear in gain function? A zero will appear. So that means there is a partial feed forward path is going on. Is that clear to you? So if there are zeros, this means there is some feed forward is going on anyway. Is that clear? Otherwise poles will always give you feedback. Is that correct? This is what the technique is to know what whether we are doing correctly or not. Okay, here is an example which is very simple and very easy to understand. Let us say I have a source follower, emitter follower, which is essentially called common collector circuit. Please remember the other name of emitter follower is common collector circuit. Okay, collector is grounded at the VCC. Grounded means to go to VCC. There is a source VS, there is a source resistance RS, there is a load which is RE. Please remember this RE itself is the load for source amplifier. There is no additional load, it may have also, but right now for this we will just take RE. And output is taken across this. Equivalently saying, this is a VBE for the transistor. Please remember RE is common to the mesh of the voltage drop across RE is common in this mesh. Do you see this mesh? In this mesh, the drop across RE is in series with VS, is in series with VS. So what mixing I am doing? Series mixing, okay. However, if I short V0, nothing goes inside the feedback. So what sampling I am doing? Across I am sampling. So what is this? Shunt sampling and series mixing. So what amplifier I have? Series shunt amplifier. Is that clear? If I short V0, no feedback. Drop across RE becomes 0, so nothing changes in the input, no feedback in the input. So it is essentially voltage feedback which is shunt across the output, okay. So it is a shunt sampled. At the input side, if you see this mesh, this drop across RE is in series with the source. So you have a series mixing and shunt sampled. So it is series shunt sample, or it is essentially called voltage amplifier. It is called voltage amplifier. What is series? We said then the feedback signal is in series with the source, and that can only be voltages. That current cannot be in series with something, isn't it? So only voltage can be in series. So if you look at this input loop, input circuit, the drop across RE, which is common, which is the feedback, see V0 by this much is the current drop across this VF. That is in series with the signal. You can see this. In this is actually twice, one because of IA and one because of this. But for the input side, this current takes care of the drop across this. So whatever voltage VF here is in series with the signal. Whenever there is a mesh, the two voltage sources can be in series. They may be plus or minus, depends on the signs. But they will be in series. If you have a node like this, there is a current here, there is a current here, and something like this. What is the mixing done here? I can add a node I brought, let us say this is one I1, this is I2, and this is I3. So I3 is I1 plus I2. So it is node mixed. That means current is getting mixed. Is that correct? Which is essentially shunt to the input circuit. Current is always shunt. Source, is that correct? So we say whenever there is a current feedback going on at the series at this, it is a shunt feedback going on, shunt mixing is going on. If the voltage across the feedback network is in series with the source, then we say it is a series mixing. Is that correct? That is a voltage mixing. Please remember series cannot be currents, it always will be voltages. So it is therefore voltage input, voltage output. So what amplifier I am looking for? A voltage amplifier. V0 by Vs is my A. Is that correct? That is the way I have figured it out. So it is a series shunt amplifier, which we have already done earlier, but let us do it again. Okay. just to say again, since RE is common between input and output, this amplifier is a voltage amplifier circuit. Now we want to find circuit without feedback. Okay. I repeat, I want to find AOL, which is, I say, circuit without feedback, but what is the condition I am still forcing you? Do not neglect the feedback components, because if you neglect them, then the feedback part will all, this will become normal amplifier, there is no question of feedback there. So if we say at the input, what is the condition I said to get an input circuit? Short the output, is that correct? Short the output. So I said V0 is 0. So what things get shorted in the input side? The VF, because if V0 is 0, RE doesn't exist, it is a short circuit. Please look at the circuit again. If V0 is shorted here, this is grounded. If V0 is grounded, this is grounded. Okay. So in the input side, I have RE bypassed now by short. Okay. This is my input circuit now. This is my input circuit. Now to get an output circuit, what is the condition I told you? Short input. So okay, if I short input, II is 0. If we make II 0, there is dependent source on the output, we have circuit only in the, what happens here? If I say this is going down, the GM times that will also go away. Okay. So what will remain at the output therefore? Only the RE factor, GM times parallel RE, but GM itself will be open circuit, GM VI. Current source is open circuit. So what is the resistance seen there at the output? RE. So that's the circuit I put. This is my input circuit, this is my output circuit. Is that correct? So this is which amplifier now I am calling this amplifier? It's a open loop amplifier for the feedback circuit amplifier given to me. Take an for to get an input circuit, short V0, and then whatever you see in the inputs, that is your input circuit. To get an output circuit, short inputs, but as soon as you short input, GM VI will open up because there is no current source then. Then the only resistance, of course there is a RO, but right now I say RO is infinite. So the only resistance left is RE at the, please remember you see circuit again and again. So if I see from here and this is this, the only resistance I see is RE, nothing else at the output. Is that correct? So if that happens, then the equivalent circuit of a transistor now is a common emitter amplifier with RE as a load, drop across RE is the feedback voltage, and then I write equivalent circuit of this, this is VSR pi, okay, bipolar hai, VSR pi, GM V pi, this is my emitter, this is my base, this is my collector. GM V pi parallel R0, if you want to make R0 infinite, you can make that parallel RE, and then I can get the gain of this amplifier. Kya hoga gain bina maine kuch liye, kitna gain hoga? Ye V pi hai na, kitna hoga? GM V pi times RO parallel RE is the output voltage, but V pi is how much? R pi upon R pi plus S times signal, is that okay? Potential divider, ye voltage kitna hai? This voltage ka divider hai, this upon this plus this into V S is V pi. So substitute V pi in the output, so V0 by which is GM R pi ROE up, ROE is the parallel combination, I make R pi plus R S. So this is my open loop gain. Is that clear to you? How did I get my open loop gain? I got my input circuit, I got my output circuit, then I made a new amplifier now for me, and I got the gain for this amplifier, which I say it's open loop amplifier gain. See, normally it is a common emitter amplifier. We have seen what is for a common emitter amplifier, what is the load resistance we are seeing, output resistor, which is RE. So it is across collector to emitter. That is the equivalence, that is what I keep saying. It is not symmetric, same as what we have. It is source amplifier, common emitter amplifier, sorry, common collector amplifier, that is emitter followers, have an equivalence with the feedback of that RE is of this kind in open loop. This is something you have to appreciate. This is the output resistance RE I got. What is output resistance will be across what? It will be always across collector to emitter. Okay, that is the output resistance of an amplifier. Substitute there. Okay, then solve this. Once I get this, then how do I get the gain? Okay, before the, what is beta? Unity. It's same voltage na, wohi feedback pe gaya hai. So beta is 1. So the return loop gain T is AOL beta, which is this function. And then the feedback gain or a closed loop gain is AOL upon 1 plus T. Substitute these values here and you get beta ROE upon R pi plus RS. Now I am now giving you a case. This already we have solved source amplifier. Is that clear? We already solved normal common source, source follower and emitter followers. Don't use feedback theory. What do I do? Don't use any feedback theory. I actually solve equivalent circuit for this. Is that as it is? Then evaluate this gain for that V0 by Vs and verify whether using this AOL upon 1 plus T kind of function, is this expression is same as what I would have got if I would not have assumed any fee, I just solve the network. Okay. Verify yourself. And you will be surprised it is exactly what we got otherwise. Okay. And why positive sign is coming everywhere? Because source followers or emitter followers has a same phase outputs as inputs. Okay. By same logic we have earlier said, what is RIF for such shunt, series shunt amplifier? RIF is 1 plus T times RI. What is RI? This is 1 plus T. What is RI? Please look at our circuit, equivalent circuit. What is RI? Is only R pi. Please look at the circuit. What is RI here? R pi. R pi times 1 plus T is the RIF. That is what we have already said, series shunt amplifier. We have evaluated RI, RI, RIF, ROF already for in terms of RI and RO. So I substitute here. And I get roughly, if I solve it, R pi plus beta ROE. Do you recollect this very well? That we said if there is a source follower or emitter follower, its input impedance actually increases by beta times the feedback, whatever RE they have, plus R pi. This may be very small, actually, this may be much larger value. So the input resistance of a series shunt amplifier is very high, very high. Okay, that is what essentially we want. That is why it is called what? What is the other name for common name, this source followers or emitter followers? Buffers. The buffers have larger input resistance and smaller output resistance. So let us calculate output resistance. You can do yourself, that is not a big issue. What did we calculate for this shunt sample RO? RO by 1 by T. We have done all that. What is essentially RO for this? Small RO. Please remember RE is outside, it's a load. So the only resistance is RO for this. So RO upon 1 plus T, if I substitute it, RS plus R pi by beta, beta being very high. RS is typically few hundred ohms, R pi is typically 1 or 2 kilo ohms. So it's say at best 2 kilo ohms by 100. So how much it will be? 2 kilo ohms by 100. 20 ohms, is that correct? Let us say it is, this whole becomes 2k divided by 100, how much it is? So the output resistance of a emitter follower is very, very low, typically of the order of, for example, I gave you say 20 ohm, 50 ohm kind. And how much is the input resistance will be? Let us say RE is 1 kilo ohm, so how much is RI will be, RIF? Beta times RE, it is hundreds of k, is that correct? Hundreds of k. Is that what we did in normal source or emitter follower? You can verify once again. I repeat, yes, RE is what? RE is shunting load is, let us say 1 k. So in feedback it is 100 k at the input side, beta times Re, it will be reflected. So input resistance will rise to hundreds of k, okay, whereas output resistance will be how much? 10 to 20 or 50 ohms. So buffer requirement, that the unity gain with high input impedance and low output impedance is achievable by source follower or emitter followers, and this problem can be solved using feedback. Is that correct? Whatever analysis we did without feedback knowing also, we solved the network equivalent circuit, rakha network solve kiya, okay. Wo sab bhi jo karenge, usse result yahi aaya. That means our feedback, you are asking the verify. Here is a verification, okay. You verify both value. There will be some small change may occur because of some approximation we are making here there, but if you don't make any approximation, they will be identical in both cases, okay. Is that okay? This is a technique which essentially we use in feedbacks, okay. So what is the method? I repeat, what is the method I suggested? First find topology, then find what is the mixing going on, sampling going on. Once we know what is their Ri and Rof can be, because either by 1 plus t or multiplied by or divided by whatever the topology I get. I also know, for to get an open loop circuit, first I say short input, find the output, short output, find the input, make a new amplifier using this input output circuit with a transistor as usual. Solve the gain for that, that is your AOL. If you know the topology, you know the beta, whether current by voltage, current by current, voltage by volt, whatever you are getting. So you know the beta, you know beta, you know AOL. So you know AOL upon 1 plus AOL beta is your common closed loop gain. Is that clear? With feedback, I told you that output resistance is defined for the transistors and not for the loads. Re is the load. Yeah. But that is, we will take always as seen by the transistor. RO is the resistance as seen by the transistor. Any external component you do not add to it. Is that correct? That is the definition we say. The final RIF or ROF will be shunted or by this and whatever the other side. Is that point clear? The actual, someone asks you RIF, so you calculate that, okay. Then you say the net RIF dash, whatever you call, then you are looking from the source side and you are looking from the actual output side. Then whatever parallel or series combinations they get, you write for them. So in this case, whatever ROF I got shunted by RE, whatever I got here RIF in series to this. Is that clear? So that method remains, where to calculate, yaha karna hai ya yaha karna. First we always calculate at the input of the amplifier, at the output amplifier, and then actual outputs with loads and actual current, voltage or current sources, waha bhi nikal sakte. But that is, once you know this, this is only additional. Is that clear? But the definition wise we always do this. Is that clear? This is nothing to say that why we do not want to use the other values, because the source things I do not know, what is RS value, what is RE value. So I say intrinsically itna hai. अब जो भी कंपोनेंट लगाएंगे वो उसको मॉडिफाई कर देंगे. इज दैट करेक्ट? दैट इज व्हाई वी डोंट वांट टू यूज दोज वैल्यूज इन अवर एक्चुअल डेफिनेशंस. इज दैट क्लियर? बट यू आर राइट, द एक्चुअल इंपेडेंस फेस विल बी समवेयर एट द आउटपुट साइड. सो वो उसको देखो किसके पास पैरेलल होके किसके या सीरीज में आ रहा है, वैसा जोड़ो, बाकी सब्सट्रैक्ट जो भी करना है जैसे भी वो करो फिर. ओके, इफ आई एन इक्विवेलेंट सर्किट ऑफ दैट जीएम वी whatever V pi we are doing, if the source is 0, then the GM V pi is 0, which means current source is in open circuit. So the only impedance seen by me was RE there, okay. If that, if there be VB and GM VB aata, to wo 1 upon GM waha aata, aisa nahi hua, to usko hata diya humne. Is that okay? Okay, so these techniques which I suggested, maybe one more example on the MOS will clarify some more doubts. शंट शंट एम्पलीफायर है, अभी मैं पहले बोल दिया शंट शंट, अभी आप कहो तो आप वेरीफाई कर लो. हियर इज अ करंट नोड, एज सुन एज आई से करंट फीडबैक इधर से आ रहा है आरएफ के साथ में, ऐसा ऑफ कोर्स योर प्लस माइनस साइन यू करेक्टली डिसाइड, फीड फॉरवर्ड मत लेना. सो व्हाट वी से, एज सुन एज आई मेक वी जीरो, there is no current at the input, is that correct? As soon that means its feedback is removed by me, which essentially means this is a what sampling I am done, a shunt sampling I did. And when I say at this site, at this node, all three currents can meet, so it can change at the node any current, and therefore it is shunt mixing. So I have a shunt mixing and shunt sampling. So this is shunt shunt amplifier. Fir se ek bar khud dekho, verify kar lo. Jo method abhi tak batayi hai waisa ka waisa isme apply karo aur verify kar lo jo maine kiya hai ki this shunt shunt amplifier. So we first figure out what is the topology. So I said it is shunt shunt by, actually I knew it because I am actually seeing it. Yahan node hai aur yahan iska zero karne se ja raha hai, to ye shunt shunt hai. Is that okay? V0 zero karo, no feedback, current zero kar diya wahan se. Okay, so voltage sample ho gaya hai, that means shunt sample hua. Is yes, if V0 is zero, no current from the output is going to the input side, this is a zero potential, is that clear? So we said as soon as I get output 0, no feedback. V0 0 kiya, that means I am sampling voltage. No, this sign I have just made for the, do not see IF will be in below down actually. If you wish you can always use plus or minus sign, that is why I say we always write signs as they actually appear, okay, as they actually appear. At a node this will only plus or minus it will do. So signs will be correctly done whenever. I just wanted to show you at a node, if the three currents meet, the sampling must be, mixing must be how much? Shouldn't be shunt max mixing, because currents are getting actually shunted to each other. Okay. Okay. So this shunt shunt amplifier of a MOS, I can now show you how do I do it. Here is the circuit equivalent. Your GM VGS is your source. This is gate to source. Right now I assume source voltage is 0 and this is my RF, is that correct? From drain to gate is my feedback resistor RF, is that circuit clear? Drain to gate is the feedback resistor RF. This is GM VGS R0, this is my RD and this is my source. Now to get an open loop, okay, I said V0 0, input circuit dhundna hai na, so what should I do? Short V0, as soon as I short V0, this terminal goes to 0, whole of this terminal is going to 0, that means RF ka dusra terminal kahan ja raha hai? Kahan ja raha hai? Ground pe, ye ground pe aa gaya, is that okay? As soon as I make V0 0, this terminal is ground, so is source was ground. So that means the RF is between gate and source, RF resistance appears when the V0 goes to 0. So the input circuit has a resistance shunting there as RF, is that clear? Okay. To get in output circuit, what should I do? I said short the input, okay. If let Vin equal to 0, even this goes to 0, so opens it. So what is the output resistance? See output things I see, RO, RD. Now this is shorted. Please remember, this other terminal is shorted now. So where it will now come? From this to the ground. So now I see RO, RD, RF in parallel at the output node. Is that correct? At the input what is there? RF shunting gate and source. At the output I have three resistances in parallel shunting the output, RO, RD and RF. Ye kaun sa amplifier ke liye banaya ja raha hai? Open loop, is that correct? This is for getting the AOL, but remember I have not removed, what does that mean without feedback? So what would I have done otherwise without feedback? Mein kya karte aap? RF ko hata le. और जैसे RF को हटा लिया उसका ओपन लूप हो गया हो, दैट इज ट्रू, बट देन दीज वैल्यूज वुड नेवर हैव बीन सीन बाय ओपन लूप केस. सो द लोडिंग इफेक्ट ऑफ द वैल्यूज कैन नॉट बी निग्लेक्टेड इन इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ ओपन लूप गेन्स, दो फीडबैक इज स्टिल ब्रोकन बाय अस. यू कैन सी नाउ इफ आई से इक्विवेलेंट सर्किट ऑफ दिस, this is the input side RF, this is the output side. Now there is no connection between input and output. So this is open loop. This is input, this is output, no connection from drain to gate. So I have broken that, so I have made it open loop. But what is the criteria I have chosen? That the loading of RF I have not neglected. Loading of RF I have not neglected. Though broken, I have certainly broken the feedback. Okay. This is called open. So this, is it point clear? It is different from what we call without feedback world. Because without feedback means you would have just taken RF out. Is that correct? So we are not taking RF out. We are saying for feedback, break it into so that as if there is no output input connections. Equivalently saying this is the circuit. Okay, since it is the shunt mixing means it should have a current source. So voltage by current is the amplifier. So AL is V0 by IS star. Star I am making for open loop. Okay, star I am only trying to make it open loop. So AL is VO star upon IS star, which is VO star by Vin into Vin by IS star. This method, do you know how? Don't write directly V0 by IS. Essentially what do? V0 by Vin into Vin by IS star. Ye cancel ho raha hai. But this value I know by a normal amplifier. How much is this? V0 by Vin minus GM times the load. Kitna hoga output yahan VO star? GM Vin times RODF. So VO star by Vin is GM RODF. Minus mein hai, minus sign hai. How much is Vin by IS star? RF, there is nothing else, so into RF. Okay. So I got, now correspondingly RI if you see is only RF, correspondingly RO if you see it is only RODF. Ye kitna resistance hai RODF, ye kitna hai RI, itna hi hai resistance hamare paas. What is the feedback factor here I should use? Which kind of amplifier I said it is? Shunt shunt. Input pe current ja raha hai aur output se voltage sample ho ke aaya hai. So IF star by V0 is 1 upon RF. Kitna current feedback se aaya? IF. Wo kitna hona chahiye? Wo jo resistance mein jitna tha utna hi. Beta, please take it verify. IF times RF is V0. Okay. So uska ratio hi kiya maine. So feedback factor is 1 upon RF. So abhi kya cheeze pata lag gayi? We know our AOL, we know our beta. So what we can calculate? Closed loop or feedback gain. Okay, that I did. Aap khud karke dekho to aapko jyada samjhega, par maine aapko dikhaya methods. Closed loop gain is VO. Please remember it is still voltage by current. So which amplifier I am talking in the real sense, not voltage, which is this amplifier? Trans resistance amplifier. This is trans resistance amplifier. Okay. So if I substitute all this, aisa game khela. So par humko kya chahiye rehta hai amplifier mein? What do you really need in normal amplifier? It may be trans resistance, it may be trans conductance, it may be current. At the end kya dekhna chahte hum? Voltage gain. At the end hum kya dekhna chahte hai? Voltage gain. So humko actual nikalne ko kaha tha V0 by Vin, par humne to nikala abhi V0 by IS. Okay. So V0 by Vin can be written as V0 by IS into IS by Vin, do part mein kar diya. V0 by IS to abhi maine nikal hi liya yahan se, abhi mujhe kya nikalna hai? IS by Vin. Okay, so if, no, I don't write this, this you write now, don't do anything. Now this V0 by IS is GM RODF RF, ye jo ye hai, upon 1 G, this, ye to RF RF cancel ho gaye. Now how much is IS by Vin? Aapke circuit mein dekho na, IS by Vin kitna hai? 1 upon RF. Aapke input circuit mein dekho na, kitna IS by Vin? 1 upon RF. Multiply kiya, so ye function aya. This is your essentially the voltage gain, closed loop voltage gain of feedback amplifier. What kind of feedback amplifier we started with? Shunt shunt. Okay, this is a shunt shunt amplifier. Iska kya fayda ho sakta hai, ghata ho sakta hai? Iska RI jyada hoga ke kam hoga? RF जो है feedback, क्या please look at your circuit and tell me your tables. In case of shunt amplifier, does RI increases or RO increases? RI should decrease, current is subtracting out of it, so it is a negative feedback. So RI to decrease ho gaya, but RO jo hai 1 plus T times bad gaya. So it is opposite of what we did in the case of source follower or emitter follower. There input impedance rose, output impedance went down. By making a trans resistance amplifier, I can now make opposite of that. Decrease the RI and increase RO. So this, is that clear to you? What is the feedback is trying to do? Feedback is trying to play whatever specs you are looking for. By choice of proper feedback topology, I can achieve RI, RO and gains of my choice. Is that clear? Is that point clear? Why feedback? Because feedback allows me to tailor my input resistance, output resistance and the gain, and that is something which normal amplifier does not allow me. Is that if I take a source amplifier, I cannot do much of that, it will always be one kind. Okay. Feedback allows me to play. Okay. That is why feedback amplifiers, and what is the most important thing in feedback we are getting? It gain becomes constant, very close to a constant. Why it becomes constant in negative feedback? If there is a change of signal due to noise at the input, and let us say it is plus, then what will become to the output? Additional voltage will appear at the output. So during feedback, what it will do? It will start, that also will be higher now, correspondingly beta times V0. So the input will further rise now. It will rise, but it will subtract. So in net input will go down. So the output will go down. Since output went down, feedback reduces. So it will start again till it balances to the normal value. So feedback stabilizes the gain, and it also allows me to make different RI, different RO, and different ACLs. Is that correct? That is why feedback amplifiers are always utilized. Please remember, instead of RF, what is normally will be present in the case of all amplifiers, this, I did not put RF there, but what component will be always there in a MOS transistor? Which capacitor? CGD. So please remember, CGD is a shunting actually between output to the input, and it will give you a shunt mix. Is that correct? So it will also try to stabilize you. Okay, with that impedance of that frequency. The only problem, why it is so different from this, because it is a frequency dependent impedance. R is constant, but omega C, different omega will have different this. So at certain frequency it may have certain different phenomena, at other frequency it may have other phenomena, but that is what we want frequency response to be modified. Okay, that is what CGD, CGS and others will actually help us to achieve that. Is that point clear? This is an issue which you should always understand, that feedback is a generalized network and sometimes inbuiltly present, sometimes you may actually put it. Okay. When I say I put RF, in reality what do I put in such circuit? RF parallel CGD. So it is an impedance which I am putting there. Is that clear? So there is some kind of a pole function starts appearing because of this RC network which I am going to put there. Is that clear? So if the pole changes, then what changes? Bandwidth. So you have to see that what kind of amplifiers will improve the bandwidth or decrease the bandwidth. Is that correct? These are the techniques of controlling the bandwidth, the gain and the RI, RO. Okay. That is why I say feedback is very, very important phenomena. I am not going to do a great part of stability, because why I was thinking to teach you a lot of things on that, Nyquist criteria, root locus method, but then you know I will go to the control side bit too much. Let us take that expression in closed loop, AOL upon 1 plus T. I am looking for stability with feedback. If T is positive, what does that mean? If T is positive means 1 plus T is higher, means closed loop gain will be smaller than open loop gain. Is that correct? Denominator will be larger, so obviously you will get smaller gains. Okay. What is the feedback? Essentially we say when this can occur, only when negative feedback is present. Okay. However, if t is less than 0, then the denominator will actually enhance, divide by smaller value, it will actually enhance the ACL. And if it enhances the ACL, if it is negative, then it will enhance. And if that enhances, what is the kind of thing will happen? If the feedback signal is always in same sense as the input, what will increase? The net input. If the net input increases, what will increase? The net output. The feedback will bring back additional input now, which is in series, which is in plus to the input itself. So further increase of input, further increase of output, what is it going to do? So at any given instant of time, I do not know what is V0, because V0 is constantly increasing, increasing, increasing. Is that correct? V0 return to the series of that increases V0, further loop mein V0 badhta jaye. Usko kya bolenge phir? Amplifier does not have any known gain. Is that correct? Because every instant of time V0 is not known to me. Okay. So we say such amplifiers are unstable or they show instability. Would you like such things to happen for your amplifier? Why did we do feedback all this for this purpose? Ki nahi gain constant ho jaye, jo humko 10 chahiye, 50 chahiye, 100 chahiye. We want that fixed. Is that correct? With nothing changing, this gain should not change. Everything changing, but this gain should not. Abhi to aapne positive feedback kiya, to waise hi sab badh raha hai. Growth pattern shuru ho gaya. So such will not be an amplifier. Is that correct? It will not be a amplifier for known gains. So any time positive feedback appears, we say we have instability. Is that correct? So guarantee kya karna hai aapko amplifier design mein? What should be our guarantee? That it should always be negative feedback. Ab aap ek socho, output jo hai V0 is a function of frequency. If the input is a function of frequency, so if the output will be a function of frequency. So there are two factors of any this T factor, which is loop gain. If you see a loop gain, will it be a real quantity or an imaginary quantity or a complex quantity? A is a complex, so is A beta will be a complex quantity, T will be a complex quantity. Is that correct? So if it is a complex quantity, how do we represent any complex number? A plus JB is equal to magnitude of this value into e to the power j omega or j phi, which is the phase part for that. Is that correct? Any complex function can be represented like this. Is that correct? Tan inverse, imaginary by real, is the phase for that. So you have not only amplitude, but also you have a phase. So now look at a situation which is very interesting. This itna simple samajh mein aa gaya to aapko easily sab feedback samajh mein aa jayega. Ye input hai, ye ek network ke through aapko yahan aa raha hai. This is much easier to explain. The closed loop gain is AS upon AS, instead of AOL I am just removing OL, AS upon 1 plus AS beta S. Now my I am using little generalized. What is generalization I did from the earlier one? What is beta I am showing you? That may be also a function of frequency. Right now, normally what is the kind of betas we have used so far? They are real values and there is no complex term with them. Okay. But let us say it is also function of, theek hai, usko bhi general kar dete. So we write at for a frequency ACL at j omega is a j omega 1 plus a j omega b j omega. The loop gain T is A j omega into B j omega is certainly a complex function. Okay. How do I write complex function? The magnitude of A omega, A j omega, this e to the power j phi, which is a function of omega. Phi is the phase. What is phase? By definition of complex number, tan inverse imaginary by real value. So that is, and that is how we represent any complex value. Now look at the situation little carefully in that figure. let us say feedback is coming, okay. So it has some magnitude. What is being returned? Return has some value which has magnitude and also has a phase. If even if let us say the gain magnitude is higher than 5, 10, 20, okay, but the phase is such that the return signal opposes the input signal. So what it, which kind of feedback it will give me? Negative feedback, is that correct? There is on the AL itself, oh yes itself, there is a phase shift. What is the phase shift between input and output for the AS? How much degrees? 180 degree, amplifier shows phase out. So there is a 180 degree is the normal input to output. On the return path, because the complex function, there is a phase going on. If this phase is also 180 degree, how much is the net phase it will give you? 180 there and 180 here. So how much is the phase now? 360 degree or 0, you are right. So what the, now let's say the amplitude is positive, then what will it will do? If the phase becomes 0 means in phase to the input, which kind of feedback essentially I have gone into? Positive feedback. The gain is not less than 1, gain is higher than 1, okay, but the phase was such that it is 180 degree from the feedback and 180 degree from the amplifier. So the return signal to the input is in phase with input, which is higher now because your A beta is higher, you have chosen 10 let us say, okay. So now what is happening, that your input has increased, output will increase and input will, so which system has become stable or unstable? Unstable. So it is not just the magnitude but also the phase, is that correct? So can you think from this, a very simple calculations which we do, if we say at the frequencies of operations which we are looking, if the gain does become, where is the gain will become 0 dB? At the omega t term, that is the unity gain point. So if we see for the loop gain itself alone, when it will become, when it becomes 1 t j omega is 1 magnitude wise, we say at that frequency, if the phase of this function is how much? Less than 180 degree, I repeat, less than 180 degrees, which feedback I am still talking? Negative feedback. But if the gain is positive and feedback this has already crossed 180 degree phase, then what will happen? The feedback will become positive. I repeat, the gain is positive, it has not crossed 0 dB loop gain for example, and its phase has crossed 180 degree, okay, or reached at 180. So now what will happen? There is a positive return, positive value which is in phase return to the input, is that clear? So which feedback I am now getting into? Positive feedback. System will become unstable. So the two term we define, one we call phase margin and the other we will call gain margin. If the phase margin is positive, we will see that, then we say system will remain stable. If the phase margin becomes negative, then we say system will become unstable. So all feedback amplifier people try to see what is the phase margin they are getting, is that correct? If the phase margin is positive, be assured that, what does that essentially mean, phase margin is negative means, when the gain becomes less than 0 dB or less than 1, your phase is still negative, is that correct? So it has not returning signal and the gain has already crossed 1, so it is partially is only returning now, much lower is returning and you are always opposing that value, is that correct? So what does that mean? That if the Bode's plot, think of it, something on the Bode's plot, if your 0 dB point crossed by the magnitude at which point the phase is still not 180 degree or 0 essentially, 180 plus 180, then what do we say? The negative feedback exists. If that crossed before, after this, then we say it is a positive feedback and we have a instability. So is that point clear? So in amplifiers, it is not only the amplitude which is also, there is a problem of phase, and that is what essentially the stability is all about. Okay, just even to give you a basic idea, any generalized transfer function in a feedback can be written as, isko hi expand kiya, to AF0 1 upon, there may be large number of poles, A1S by 1 plus, with feed, this is all with feedback. Is transfer function ko is tarah se likha ja sakta hai, generalized form mein, A1 plus A2 plus A3, S square, S cube, S4, Sn, kitne bhi pole ho sakte hai. What does this essentially means? If there is a S cube term, how many poles are there? 3 poles. If only first this term present, there is a single pole. So depending on your transfer function of closed loop amplifier system, first find how many poles are there, then draw its Bode diagram. What do we draw then? Bode diagram. So what I do is the following. Okay, here is some my definition, I will come back to it again. As I say, we can dwell on this detailed theory of feedback, it is a huge game, interesting game, rather much more interesting than many things I taught, because I like it, that is what it is, root locus technique. It is a very funny thing, Nyquist criteria, how many times you circle the pole, very nice thing to learn. Okay, आपको एक फिगर दिखा देते हैं जिससे आपको थोड़ा सा एक स्टेबिलिटी का आइडिया आ जाए. ये सिंगल पोल है, आई हैव प्लॉटेड फॉर द ट्रांसफर फंक्शन सॉरी लूप गेन ए सिंगल पोल थ्योरी, सिंगल पोल एज आई प्लॉट फॉर द एम्पलीट्यूड एंड दिस इज दिस फेज. एट दिस पॉइंट व्हाट इज द गेन? लूप गेन इज हाउ मच? 1. लेस देन 0 वो पॉजिटिव होता है ना, तो पहले 1 ही है अभी. इसके नीचे वो माइनस हो रहा है, ठीक है, इसके ऊपर प्लस है. एट दिस फ्रीक्वेंसी इफ आई प्लॉट माय फेस करस्पॉन्डिंगली 45 डिग्रीज पर डिकेड एंड इट इंटरसेक्ट्स एट पॉइंट लेट्स से सम 160 डिग्री माइनस, हाउ मेनी, व्हाट इज द फेस देयर? माइनस 160 डिग्री. देन आई से आई put another value where the phase becomes 180 and I get the value of frequency at which that has happened. So this value, is that correct? At this point, this is the gain, at this gain, this is the phase. At this frequency, this is the phase, at this phase, this is the gain. Is that clear? So we say, at this, for the loop gain, from this value where the T has become 1 or 0 dB, you add 180 degree to it, okay, or subtract minus 180 means add 180 degree to it. If that quantity is positive, that is, this number is called phase margin. What is phase margin? This value, phase at this point where the T is 1, minus of minus 180 means plus 180. So 180 minus this phase value, if you do, and if this value remains positive, then what is the phase margin will be called? Positive phase margin. We have just now said if it is less than 180 degree, the output signal will never be in phase by feedback to the input. So which feedback it will retain? Negative feedback, because the signal is not returning to same phase, 180 from the amplifier, 180 from here, so 360 degree nahi ho raha hai. So as long as this is less than 180 degree, system will remain always stable. Is that correct? So what is the criteria I am saying? If the phase margin is positive, the system is always stable. When this would have occurred, let us say at this value, or this, when the gain has become, यहां पर समझो ये एक वैल्यू है गेन की, और समझो ऐसा कुछ हो जाता, ऐसा अभी होगा नहीं बट ऐसा समझो होता. सो यू हैव रीच 180 डिग्री, सॉरी यहां पर यू हैव रीच 180 डिग्री बट द गेन इज स्टिल पॉजिटिव, इज दैट करेक्ट? सो विच फीडबैक इट वुड हैव गिवन? नेगेटिव, पॉजिटिव फीडबैक. So if the phase margin becomes 0 or negative, the system will become unstable. As long as the phase, and what is the definition of phase margin? There should be the phase of T plus 180. Why it is plus? I wrote minus of minus 180 is plus 180. So 180, and this will be minus. So if the net value is positive, then we say feedback is always negative. Otherwise, feedback is positive and system will become unstable or instability starts. Is that point clear? Is the definition clear to you? I repeat, if the return signal is in phase as is more than unity, which means it will add to the signal and output will grow. Is that correct? If it is not in, it opposes the input, it will always reduce the V0 and therefore it will never grow. Is that clear? So for stability, negative feedback is essential, and to do this, phase margin must be retained to less than or greater than 0 degree, or rather prefer, what is typical amplifier phase margin should be for normal good this. Remember, 45 degrees per decade ek capacitor deta hai, theek hai, phase mein do aaya to 90 kar denge uske. To iska kya matlab hai ki minimum kitna rakhna chahiye, unknown ek capacitor kahin se yadi feedback par aa gaya, unknown yani isko kya bolte hai, aise kaun se capacitor jo unknown rehte hain, parasitic, वो आपको सिस्टम को अनस्टेबल बना सकते हैं. तो कम से कम 45 डिग्री तो भी आप फेज मार्जिन रखिए, जिससे आप गारंटीडली उसको नेगेटिव फीडबैक में. नॉर्मली फेज मार्जिन फॉर नॉर्मल एम्पलीफायर शुड बी केप्ट बिटवीन 45 to 60. अब मैं अभी आपको नहीं बताऊंगा, पर सोचो यदि फेज मार्जिन 80 कर दिया, 90 कर दिया, और भी अच्छा स्टेबल होना चाहिए ना, तो कुछ तो भी और चला जाएगा. यू मे अचीव वेरी नाइस, क्या हो जाएगा, गेन ही चला जाएगा. सो यू डोंट वॉन्ट टू रिड्यूस द गेन टू मच, एट द सेम टाइम यू वॉन्ट इट टू बी स्टेबल. सो फेज मार्जिन की टिपिकल वैल्यू कितनी होनी चाहिए, 45 डिग्री टू 60 डिग्री के बीच में ही सभी एम्पलीफायर स्टेबलाइज किए जाते हैं. नॉट दैट 65 विल नॉट स्टेबलाइज, बट वॉट कॉस्ट द गेन एक्चुअली विल गो डाउन. ओके, सो ए टिपिकल अच्छा गेन और अच्छा स्टेबिलिटी के लिए फेज मार्जिन को कहाँ रखना है, 45 टू 60 डिग्री में. ये कहाँ से आते हैं फेज मार्जिन, टैन इनवर्स जो आप निकालते हैं टी फंक्शन के लिए, उनके उसमें टी फंक्शन में क्या क्या वैल्यूज है, ए और बीटा. इज दैट करेक्ट? ए में क्या क्या वैल्यू होंगे, गेन होगा, जीएम होगा, सी होगा, आर होंगे, सब होंगे वहाँ पर. उनकी वैल्यू ऐसी होनी चाहिए कि वो ये 45 डिग्री तक या उसके थोड़े ऊपर फेज मार्जिन दें. इफ दे गिव इट, देन वी से सिस्टम इज एम्पलीफायर इज ऑलवेज स्टेबल. इज दैट करेक्ट? अदरवाइज इवन इफ यू हैव थॉट इट इज स्टेबल इनिशियली, एट सम फ्रीक्वेंसी यू विल फाइंड सडनली अनस्टेबल हो गया. ओके, एंड दैट इज व्हाई आई से एम्पलीफायर डिजाइन इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग इफ यू हैव ए फीडबैक. इज दैट करेक्ट? प्लीज रिमेंबर, व्हाट इज द फेज मार्जिन आई कीप सेइंग यू, 180 plus, and this will be minus quantity. Is that correct? Because this is going down, so minus. Then at 180 degree, whatever is the gain from zero, ये zero है, और 180 पर ये gain है. Is that clear? 180 पर क्या gain है? इतना gain है. ये gain fall हुआ ना यहाँ तक, यहाँ आया. तो zero से यहाँ तक इसको बोलते gain margin. Plus है या minus है? Minus है. So यदि gain margin plus हो गया, इसका क्या मतलब होने वाला है, फेज मार्जिन निगेटिव होने वाला है या जीरो होने वाला है, उसका मतलब अनस्टेबिलिटी. तो गेन मार्जिन निगेटिव होना चाहिए और फेज मार्जिन पॉजिटिव होना चाहिए, तभी सिस्टम स्टेबल होगा. इज दैट क्लियर? इज दैट क्लियर? दिस इज समथिंग इंटरेस्टिंग विच फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर्स प्रूव. प्लीज डू दिस बिफोर वी क्विट ऑन दिस. लास्ट एक स्लाइड दिखा देते हैं, इसका फायदा कहाँ हम उठाते हैं. हमने आपको एक बोला था कि निगेटिव फीडबैक से हम फ्रीक्वेंसी बढ़ाते हैं, बैंडविड्थ बढ़ाते हैं. दैट्स व्हाट आई सेड, इजंट इट? आई शुड, डे वन आई सेड 1 + a β टाइम्स जो ओरिजिनल बैंडविड्थ होगा वो बढ़ जाएगी आपकी. तो इसका एक एग्जांपल है, मैंने सब सॉल्व नहीं किया, मैंने थोड़ा सा आपको सिर्फ दिखाया, डायरेक्ट वैल्यू एक्सप्रेशन लिख दिया मैंने. ये कैपेसिटेंस ऐसा फीड यहाँ से यहाँ लाया, कौन सा फीडबैक है ये, क्षण क्षण आउटपुट वोल्टेज से सैंपल किया गया है और नोड पेपर रिटर्न करंट दिया गया है, तो इट इज क्षण क्षण एम्पलीफायर. इज दैट करेक्ट? क्षण क्षण एम्पलीफायर. whenever I connect a capacitance between output and input, we can separate them by which method? Input side, output side, Miller's theorem. तो ये इसको बोलते हैं, जो मेथड मैं आपको बता रहा हूँ उसको बोलते हैं मिलर्स कॉम्पेंसेशन. क्या बोलते हैं? मिलर्स कॉम्पेंसेशन. अब हम एक स्टेबिलिटी का एक आइडिया देखो. समझो यदि दो पोल हैं और वो पास पास हैं, तो विल देयर फेज विल रीच 180 फास्टर? इफ द टू पोल्स आर वेरी क्लोज, 90 से नीचे आना शुरू होगा ना, 90 डिग्री. सो तो 180 आने में तो बिफोर 10 टाइम्स होने के पहले वो 180 पहुंच सकते हैं, 10 टाइम होते होते. तो इसका क्या मतलब है कि गेन वुड नॉट हैव प्रोबेबली गॉन टू जीरो, बट योर फेज माइट रीच टू 180. सो व्हाट सिस्टम विल बिकम? अनस्टेबल. सो क्या चाहते हैं हम कि यदि दो पोल एक दूसरे से दूर रहें, बहुत दूर रहें, तो जो डोमिनेंट पोल यदि पहले आ रहा है काफ़ी शिफ्ट होके, बहुत कम जगह पर जा रहा है, समझे, थोड़ा बैंडविड्थ कम करने की कोशिश की गई है, तो क्या हो जाएगा? फेज विल नेवर रीच 180 बाय देन. इज दैट करेक्ट? बिफोर द गेन क्रॉसेस जीरो. इन दैट केस व्हाट विल हैपन देन? सिस्टम विल रिमेन स्टेबल, बट एट व्हाट कॉस्ट? बैंडविड्थ थोड़ी कम की मैंने, क्योंकि मैंने शिफ्ट किया उसको थोड़ा लेफ्ट में, तो उसकी बैंडविड्थ थोड़ी रिड्यूस करके मैंने क्या अचीव कर लिया? फेज मार्जिन अचीव कर लिया मैंने. सो दिस को बोलते हैं कॉम्पेंसेशन. तो क्या कर सकते हैं कि ये जो इनिशियल पोल है, समझो एक सर्किट है, अभी ये CF नहीं है, समझो फीडबैक, ओके, एक इक्विवेलेंट सर्किट है, R1 एक रेजिस्टेंस है, C1 एक है, ये आया है इज द करंट सोर्स, दिस इज माय V0 और I0 भी ले सकते हैं, और ये फीडबैक नहीं लिखा है, नॉर्मल एम्पलीफायर है, इसको निकाल दिया मैंने. सो व्हाट आर द टू पोल्स वी से विदाउट फीडबैक? नो CF. It is not AL kind, it is just that there is no CF. Then R1 C1 will be one pole and R2 C2 will be other pole. So omega P1 is 1 upon R1 C1, omega P2 is 1 upon R2 C2. These are the two poles available for you. Okay. If I use this now new circuit, I evaluated the transfer function V0 by that and I evaluated the two poles. अभी आप इक्वलेंट लिख लो, ये एग्जैक्ट नहीं है, ऐसे हैं. दिस इज द पोल्स विदाउट फीडबैक, नो CF. दीज आर द टू पोल्स विथ CF. ओके, इस फंक्शन में देखो ओमेगा P1 डैश में, इफ आई इंक्रीज CF व्हाट विल हैपन? ओमेगा P1 क्या बढ़ेगा कि कम होगा? कम होगा, यानी लोअर साइड में जाएगा, कम होगा यानी लोअर साइड में, तो बैंडविड्थ थोड़ी कम हो रही है. ठीक है, ओमेगा P2 को देखो, इसको थोड़ा मैंने नाइस एक्सप्रेशन बना दिया आपके लिए, GM अपॉन C1 C2 बाय CF प्लस C1 प्लस C2. तो CF बढ़ाया तो क्या होगा? ओमेगा P2 को बढ़ेगा, यानी वो राइट साइड में शिफ्ट होगा. तो डू यू सी, बाय चॉइस ऑफ ए CF आई एम सेपरेटिंग टू पोल्स P1 एंड P2. स्प्लिट, समझ में आया वर्ड स्प्लिट क्यों हुआ? ये किधर गया? लेफ्ट में. ये किधर गया? राइट में. तो पहले यदि पास थे तो उन दोनों को मैंने सेपरेट कर दिया. किस मेथड से किया सेपरेट? शंट कनेक्शन दिया CF का. सो आई नाउ फिगर आउट बाय चॉइस ऑफ CF वैल्यू आई कैन मूव द सेकेंड पोल टू माय राइट एंड वन पोल टू माय लेफ्ट. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड स्प्लिटिंग. सो द टू पोल को स्प्लिट कर दिया. जैसे ही मैंने टू पोल्स को स्प्लिट कर दिया, अब किसी भी हालत में जितना स्प्लिट करेंगे आप, उतना फेज मार्जिन, फेज विल नेवर रीच 180 डिग्री बिफोर क्रॉसिंग ऑफ दिस वैल्यू. इज दैट करेक्ट? आप समझ सकते हैं, यदि इसको और शिफ्ट किया तो यहां से ही जाना शुरू हो जाएगा, तो क्रॉसिंग ऑफ 0 डिग्री विल बी अर्लियर बिफोर द फेज बिकम्स 180 डिग्री. सो व्हाट डज दैट मीन? सिस्टम विल बिकम स्टेबल. सो बाय स्प्लिटिंग द पोल्स I can make even an unstable system close to stable system. What is the method I suggested? It's called splitting of poles. By adding a shunt feedback capacitor, all that I did, one of the poles I took left, other pole I shifted right, separation kar diya. Ab wo itne fastly phase decrease nahi kar payenge. Is that correct? So they may never reach 180 degree, minus 180 degree before the gain goes to 0 degree. If that happens, what is the phase margin I will get? Positive, which means system will become stable. Is that clear? So any system which is unstable can also be stabilized using feedback. Is that point clear to you? So that is the trick which we are saying. Even if the system is unstable, I have way to actually stabilize it. What things I will reduce? I will reduce the gain. I may reduce some bandwidth otherwise to some extent, but I will make system stable for you. Is that correct? This is what the feedback is all about. इसलिए स्टेबिलिटी वर्ड समझ में आ गया कि क्यों सिस्टम शुड नॉट रिमेन इन ग्रोथ पाथ, इट शुड रिमेन स्टेबल गेन्स. सो फीडबैक्स अलाउज यू टू अचीव एनी स्टेबल. ये क्यों ऐसा सब कर रहे हैं, किसके लिए कर रहे हैं? इन नेचर द इनपुट सिग्नल्स विच यू रिसीव फ्रॉम एनी ऑफ द लाइक नॉइज कमिंग और एनी ट्रांसड्यूसर यू पुट टू पिकअप टेम्परेचर्स वेरिएशंस, ऑल दीज आर इन नैनो वोल्ट्स टू माइक्रो वोल्ट्स. स्प्रिंग का है, मैकेनिकल सिस्टम्स हैं, इनके जो सोर्स हैं इनकी वैल्यू बहुत थोड़ी है. इज दैट करेक्ट? नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू डू सम प्रोसेसिंग, सो आई मस्ट फर्स्ट एम्पलीफाई देम. इज दैट करेक्ट? वंस आई स्टार्ट एम्पलीफाइंग, वट इज़ माई प्रॉब्लम? वो सिग्नल इतना छोटा है, उसका गेन बढ़ाने जाऊँगा तो मैं अनस्टेबिलिटी कर दूंगा. तो मैं क्या करूँगा? पहला स्टेज कौन सा होना चाहिए? फीडबैक ही होना चाहिए, क्योंकि वो लोअर गेन से स्टार्ट करे पर जो आउटपुट लेके आए वो स्टेबल हो. तो अब सेंसर का आउटपुट मेरे को करीब करीब फिक्स्ड मिल गया है. इज दैट करेक्ट? फिर मैं नॉर्मल गेन स्टेज भी दे सकता हूँ. इज दैट करेक्ट? सो इन ऑल इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशंस, सिग्नल प्रोसेसिंग और एनी काइंड, द फर्स्ट स्टेज इज कॉल्ड लो नॉइज एम्पलीफायर, विच इज एसेंशियली ए फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर विद ए लो गेन्स. इज दैट करेक्ट? व्हाई इट इज नेसेसरी? बिकॉज आई वॉन्ट सिग्नल टू बी स्लाइटली लार्जर देन वॉट आई, इवन इन एंटीना, जो आपका मोबाइल है इसका सिग्नल लेस देन ए मिली वोल्ट है. ओके, आपको तो कुछ सुनाई भी नहीं देगा, यदि 3G है तो दिखाई भी नहीं देगा. सो वॉट शुड वी डू? मस्ट एम्पलीफाई इट. बट एज सुन एज आई पुट ए नॉर्मल एम्पलीफायर, क्या होगा? वो एक्चुअली निगेटिव में पॉजिटिव में चला जाएगा. तो उसको बूस्ट तो करना है, पर इतना भी नहीं कि वो अनस्टेबल हो जाए. तो उसको पहले स्टेबलाइज गेन कर देते, छोटा गेन छोटी बैंडविड्थ पे पहले बूस्ट कर देते, फिर थोड़ा सा बढ़ा 10 मिली वोल्ट हुआ, फिर नॉर्मल एम्पलीफिकेशन किया जाता है. इज दैट क्लियर टू यू? दिस इज द टेक व्हाई वी आर सो वरीड अबाउट, पर्टिकुलरली फॉर ऑल सिग्नल प्रोसेसिंग एप्लीकेशंस इंक्लूडिंग कम्युनिकेशन इन नेटवर्क्स एंड एवरीवेयर, दिस विल बी द फर्स्ट स्टेज ऑफ एनी इनपुट पार्ट. इज दैट करेक्ट? सो यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई फीडबैक इज सो मच रिलेवेंट. इज दैट क्लियर? दिस फिनिशेस अवर फीडबैक पार्ट.